Hello guys, welcome back to all about structural analysis and design, and I am Abhijit Baikerikar. So we will be testing today one of the important and primary methods for the non-destructive testing, that is also known as NDT. In my previous videos, I have shown you the working of the compression testing machine. So I will be giving the link in the description box. You can just check out with that link and you can watch that operation of compression testing machine. So today's task is to experiment with this rebound hammer. So what is rebound hammer? Rebound hammer is an instrument which will give the relative compressive strength of the concrete or any building material based on its hardness on its exposed surface. Okay, so basically you require one rebound hammer, also known as Schmidt's hammer, because it was invented by Swiss engineer Ernst Schmidt. So also it is known as Swiss hammer or Schmidt's hammer or rebound hammer. So this is typical rebound hammer. I will show you the graduated scale here. So this is graduated scale in which the rebound number is mentioned. Okay, so this is a plunger in locked position. If you want to remove or unlock this plunger, what you have to do is just place it horizontally and just give a slight push. Now the plunger is in unlocked position, and also this hammer is having one lock key or lock button here. Okay, so I'll be showing you how to do this test. Okay, for this the precautions you have to remember is, first is the surface should be smooth. Okay, I am doing on the plastered surface, so there is no required to make the surface smooth. If it is not smooth, then what you have to do is you have to take this grinding stone which comes with this rebound hammer, and you have to just scratch the surface to make this surface smooth. This is the first precaution you have to remember. Okay, next precaution is very important. When there is point of contact, okay, when there is point of contact with this rebound hammer, one thing you have to remember is you have to impact this rebound hammer at least 20 mm away from the discontinuous edge or any sharp edge. This you have to remember. So you cannot do this rebound hammer test here. Okay, you have to leave at least 20 mm space and you have to conduct this test. These precautions you have to remember. And also for a detailed procedure, step-by-step procedure, if you want to follow, then there is Indian Standard Code IS 13311 part 2 1992, which is reaffirmed in 2004. So you can just go to that Indian Standard Code and you can refer the steps. So what I'll be doing is testing this structural element. Okay, you can test it vertically upwards or vertically downwards or perfectly horizontal. So I'll be demonstrating with perfectly horizontal. So what you have to do is just make sure that this lock button is in up position, upward position, and place it perfectly horizontal. Just give gentle push so that when sound comes, after this sound, just lock this button so that you'll be getting this rebound number. So here for this particular test, you are getting the rebound number somewhere around 25, okay, 25 to 26, right? Exactly it is 25 and above. You can take it as 26. For this particular point of impact, the rebound number is 26. You cannot come to conclusion only with this, only with one hammer test. You have to do it 6 times on the same point and take the average, and then you can do the rebound. Then you can say that compressive strength of that particular structural element is so and so. How to find out compressive strength is, this hammer is having one chart here. Okay, so this x-axis is based on rebound number, whatever you have got in graduated scale, and y-axis shows the compressive strength in Newton per mm square. And if you see the graph carefully, there are three curves, okay, based on the placement of hammer. Okay, first is vertically upwards, next middle one is perfectly horizontal, and the upper curve is vertically downwards. So based on the application of load of that particular hammer, you have to refer these curves. For example, for this rebound is having 26 rebound number, so you can just refer here 25 to 30 in between. So first line you can refer 26. So just move vertically and where it bisects the second curve. Why second curve? Means it is perfectly horizontal. Just come horizontal here, 26. When it touches this curve, just come here, and you can see here 18 newton per mm square. So the compressive strength of that particular test with hammer 1 is 18 newton per mm square. Like this, again 5 repetitions you have to do in that particular spot to get the average compressive strength of that structural element. Okay, and you have to remember that you have to calibrate the hammer first. How to calibrate means you have to take the standard cube of concrete, that is 150 mm into 150 mm into 150 mm. Then you have to test with this rebound hammer as well as the compression testing machine. So if the both the results matches, then you can say that, or you can use this hammer. Otherwise, if the the compressive strength is varying very much, then you have to calibrate this rebound hammer. So I hope I have cleared the doubt of this rebound hammer test. If you have liked the video, just press the like button, subscribe it and share it, and also don't forget to press the bell icon for the latest notification of these civil and structural engineering videos. Thank you guys.